Hello everyone, I'm Francesca, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Guys, I am so sorry, I did not mean to disappear like that for like a month and a half. There's been some things going on, personal things and work things and just a lot of stuff going on, and I needed a little YouTube break, so I'm really sorry. But if you follow me on Instagram and stuff, you know I've been okay and that I've been around and I'm still, you know, promoting older recipes I've done and blah, blah, blah. So I'm back, I'm here, and I'm so excited. I really miss you guys, and I really miss doing videos. Like, as I was filming these YouTube videos, like, I miss this so much. Like, I really enjoy doing videos. So today we're gonna make these Dan Dan inspired noodles. I just used things that I had in the house, things that I had around, and I will be putting all substitutions and ideas that I have for anything you can use that you might have in your house and anything, because I know this is a weird time and we can't get access to everything we normally have, so totally get that. And if you need any help with substitutions, just leave a comment down below and I'll be sure to help and give you my best opinion. So I've been seeing Dan Dan noodles everywhere, on Pinterest, on Instagram, like everywhere. I don't know why they've been popping up in my life. So I figured out how to make them. These are Dan Dan inspired noodles. This is not an authentic recipe. I did not have everything on hand to even make somewhat of an authentic recipe. So this is just my little take on them. They're spicy. They have like that beefy, meaty element, some greens. They were delicious. They're so good. And I'm gonna be like making them a lot now. Yeah, I think that's all I wanna say. As always, full recipe is down below in the description box, or you can go to my blog. There's a direct link for that right on top. You can find the recipe in both places. You will find substitutions in both places. So yeah, let's get into the recipe.
Let's start off by making our sauce. So we're gonna add about 1/4 teaspoon of red pepper flakes. You could also use cayenne pepper if you don't have red pepper flakes. Then we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of oil, any neutral oil, vegetable oil, canola oil, avocado oil. You could even use flaxseed, olive oil, whatever you have. Then we're gonna add 1 tablespoon of low sodium soy sauce. You can also use coconut aminos or tamari. 2 teaspoons of brown sugar. You can use regular sugar or maple syrup. Then I added in some apple cider vinegar, some garlic, and finally tahini. And if you don't have tahini, you can also use like a nut butter. And I just whisked that up. I gave it a taste and I wanted it spicier, so I'm adding more red pepper flakes. You can also use cayenne if you don't have red pepper flakes. And we're just gonna whisk this up. Then we're gonna head over to the stove. We're gonna add about 1/2 teaspoon of oil into a big nonstick fry pan, 3 cloves of minced garlic, some more red pepper flakes, and we're just gonna let this saute for like 2 to 3 minutes, just until everything starts to get like crackly. And then we're gonna add in 6 ounces of a vegan ground beef replacement. This is the Light Life Smart Ground, but you can also use any ground beef replacement. You can use TVP, you can use tofu, you can use crumbled up tempeh, you can use anything that replaces vegan ground beef for you, even lentils. So then I'm gonna add some soy sauce on here and just let this cook up and get crispy and golden. I'm also going to cook 1 nest of ramen. This is the ramen from Right Foods vegan chicken ramen. So I just put that in there and let that cook. Once the ground beef looks like this, we're gonna add in some bok choy that I cut up. So I was very fortunate to get bok choy in the food store. If you can't use that, you can use any leafy green, spinach, kale, you could even use broccoli. So then I just took about 1 tablespoon of the sauce that we made in 1 tablespoon of water, added that in there, and I'm just gonna let that steam until that's all wilted and a little bit crispy and caramelized and looking real good. And then we are going to take our ramen. Our ramen is all done, and I'm gonna save 1/4 cup of the ramen water. Just like pasta water, the ramen water becomes nice and starchy and helps the sauce to stick better. So we are now going to go and add that water into our sauce. And don't worry, I know it's gonna look all thin all of a sudden and you're gonna be like, Francesca, why did we just do that? Don't worry, I know what I'm doing. So then we're gonna add our ramen right in there, and then we're gonna add in our bok choy ground beef mixture. If you don't have ramen at home, you can use spaghetti and just like boil it with, I think, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, and it'll turn into ramen like bouncy noodles, or you can use any pasta, just use what you have. You could use a spaghetti or linguine. So now we're gonna toss this together and look at how good this looks. The sauce becomes completely absorbed by the noodles, by the bok choy, and this is just so good. It's spicy, it is savory. There's a really nice umami. I topped it with green onions and it just is amazing and really good. I think you guys are really going to like it. Like I said, you can substitute a lot of things in this recipe and still have something delicious that comes out. And how are these slow-mo noodles right now? Oh my goodness, yes please. I've kind of been loving slow-mo.
All right guys, and those were our Dan Dan inspired noodles. They were so good. Like, I was eating them and I could not believe actually how good they were, because I didn't think I was gonna like them as much as I did. So I hope you guys have all been staying healthy and safe. I hope you are all okay. If you are a frontline worker, thank you so much for everything you're doing. If you are somebody who is sick, I hope you get better soon. I know this is a crazy time and this is just very strange, but I don't want to harp on it because I'm trying not to. I'm trying to see, you know, positive aspects in every day and keep a schedule. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, you already know, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you to everybody who was supportive while I was not doing videos. We got a lot of new subscribers here and a lot of comments and people trying recipes, and that really means a lot to me. So I'm glad that I can help people during this time. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm so happy to be back, and I will see you soon with another video. Bye. I'm sorry that I took such a long break. It was very unintended. And Bella here, she's not happy right now. It was very unintended. These are not an authentic recipe. Please don't think they're authentic.